Yeah, hello everyone. Welcome back, or if you're new around here, welcome. Today, I'll be talking to you through how I made this chibi from the game Tower of Fantasy. I've been kinda hit with a spark of inspiration on making chibi characters lately. And since chibi art isn't really my forte, I decided to take a leap and try to do it. Most of my line work relies on pen pressure. Basically, on how soft or hard my strokes are on the screen. Like calligraphy, it somehow gives the line art a bit of character. As you may have been quite familiar with chibi drawings, they're usually drawn in bean-shaped like proportions. I know, my style doesn't really apply all of that, but I still wanted to embody the cute round shapes that makes a chibi, well, a chibi. Let's just breeze through this line art process, as this is mostly just me cleaning the sketch. Oh, before I forget, I truly apologize if the reference photos here weren't shown. A newbie mistake, really. I'll include it next time. Now that the line art's done, now is the longest part. Clean up. My art process heavily relies on the sketching phase. I put on as much information as I can on it so that when I see the piece as a whole, I can measure out whether I should continue with the illustration or just make another one. And because of this, I was able to cut my time on creating. Since previously, it took me 8 hours to 2 days creating a finished piece. Now, I can complete one in roughly 5 hours. All thanks to other artists. learning this method from them really helped me to be more efficient. All I'm doing now is cleaning up all the elements I applied on the initial phase and polishing it according to my liking. Erasing all the colors that went outside of the lines, recoloring some parts of the flats that needs it, resizing to fit the lines, or if it really doesn't fit, I'll just redo the whole thing. Now that the flat colors are done, time for some lighting. On this piece, I only did two passes of shading, which was cell shading and ambient lighting. Cell shading is a very common type of, well, shading. It's mostly seen on anime-styled art, in which hard shadows are used to tell the viewers that the light is cast from a specific location. Now, as for ambient lighting, or for a more complicated term, ambient occlusion, you know what? I'll spare you from the technical explanation. TLDR, it is used for softer and deeper shadows. I'm pretty sure most or all of my fellow gamers out there, they are familiar with this term on the graphics settings tab of their games. You may see me going back and forth a lot because there are times when I forget to add something or I totally messed up a step. Now I'm just adding really simple highlighting, nothing too fancy on this one, as I really wanted to keep the simplicity of this piece. Thank you. It's almost done. All I will do now is do some post-processing tweaks, color the line art, and we're done. I hope you all liked my art process talk through. If you like these types of videos, do let me know down in the comments. I would really appreciate it. Thankies! Bye!